Hi.
Hi. What a pretty outfit.
We are. I'm glad you like it. Thank you. I brought you something.
Oh, Daddy, you didn't have to do that.
You wouldn't have.
Come on in. I'll put him in some water.
Oh, what a big apartment.
Yeah.
And what a lovely, lovely room.
Is it?
Yes, it's yummy.
I had a decorator do it. You know, before the show, no money, since the show, no time.
He's asleep.
Oh,
finally.
Scared the daylights out of me.
Miss Nichols, that child is never going to learn anything if you keep...
Thank you, Mrs. Crawley. Dorothy Michaels, Mrs. Crawley.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know.
Nice meeting you.
Nice to meet you.
She scares the shit out of me.
Oh, scared me today.
Drop your coat here.
Who is it?
Amy's nanny. Oh. And she hates me.
Who's Amy?
My daughter.
Oh.
She was 14 months old last week.
I didn't know you had a baby.
Oh, yeah? You got any kids, Dorothy?
Oh, no.
Mm-mm. Were you ever married?
No, I haven't been that fortunate. I was engaged once, though, to a brilliant young actor whose career, unfortunately, was cut short by the insensitivity of the theatrical establishment.
It killed him?
In a manner of speaking, Sutton gave up acting, and me as well. He's working now as a waiter in a disreputable restaurant. I don't want to talk about it.
Maybe you'd like a little wine.
No, I think I better keep sharp when we work, you know.
Mind if I ask you a question?
Hmm.
Do you worry about using so much heavy makeup on your skin all the time?
No, I don't worry. I have a little mustache problem, a little sensitive to it. Probably just too many male hormones or something.
Well, some men find that attractive.
I know. I just don't like the men that find it attractive. I take it you're divorced?
Oh, no, I've never been married.
Perhaps I'll just have one little drink. Tell me about rum.
How much time you got?
Go on.
Well, Ron. Ron is hands down best director of daytime drama. Oh, did they tell you not to call it a soap yet?
Uh-uh.
There was a time when anybody called it a soap opera in front of a civilian, Rita would fine him a quarter. I think that's how she bought her Mercedes.
Now, you're not telling me about you and Ron.
That's nighttime drama. He's interesting there, too.
Oh, you mean he's... You mean you have a good relationship?
I don't know. What's a good relationship, Dottie? Well, can I call you Dottie?
Oh, please do.
Ron's smart and he's funny. We got some things in common. Listen, do you know any guy who's interested in a woman who wants her dinner at 4, is unconscious by 9, and goes to work at dawn?
But how does he treat you?
Ah, that. Well, listen, you don't think I do this without a plan, do you?
What do you mean?
There are a lot of men out there. I'm selective. I look around very carefully. And when I find the one I think can give me the worst possible time, that's when I make my move. All my lines sound like subtitles for a Czech movie.
Listen, try answering it as if the question took you by complete surprise.
What do you mean?
I'm going to ask you a question. You just answer it.
Okay.
Why do you drink so much?
When you grow up the way I did, an orphan raised by a sister 16 years older,
mm-hmm.
You've got few illusions.
There you go.
Did it make a difference?
Yes, you got it.
Oh, thanks, Dorothy.
Why do you drink so much?
Because it's not fattening, and it's not good for me. How many things can you say that about?
You tell me that I should mind my own business.
I just don't think you should worry about it. I mean, it's nice of you, but...
But I should mind my own business. Okay.
I mean, it's all so complicated, isn't it?
What?
All of it. Truthfully, don't you find being a woman in the 80s complicated?
Extremely.
You and I wished just once...
What?
That a guy could be honest enough just to walk right up to me and say, hey, listen... You know, I'm confused about this, too.
Mm-hmm.
I could lay a big line on you. We could do a lot of role-playing. But the simple truth is, I find you very interesting. And I'd really like to make love with you. Simple as that. Wouldn't that be a relief?
Heaven. tear hidden.
Ron was supposed to come over last night. I had dinner all ready for him. He never showed up.
Oh, my Lord. What time is it?
It's 10:30.
I gotta go. Listen, forgive me for rushing off like this. It was a wonderful dinner.
Dinner is burned.
I'm sorry I'm late, but listen, I was taking a shower, and really, the water got turned off, and I got soap in my eyes, I slipped on the soap, and I had to go to 5 different stores to get your favorite flavor. Chocolate chip?
Michael, I saw her.
What are you talking about? Saw who?
When you were so late, I went by your place.
When?
Tonight, and I waited outside, and I saw that fat woman go into your apartment.
Fat woman?
The one in the raincoat.
Oh, that woman, that's a friend of Jeff's. She came over to help him with the play. They've known each other for years. You really think she's fat?
Well, it was dark in the stairway, but yes, I thought she was fat. And since when does Jeff start collaborating on his play?
She's an old friend. She happens to be an excellent type. Look, Sandy, I'm not having an affair with the woman that came in my apartment, all right? It's impossible.
Michael, I don't want to make trouble. I never should have people over for dinner. They never show up. I'm sorry. I feel guilty. You feel guilty. I'm sorry.
Don't do that, Sandy. Don't apologize to me because I'm 3 hours late. You should be furious.
You've just been so great to me, Michael. You were so terrific to help me with the audition for that soap. It's that soap! Ooh, that soap! By the way, did you see that cow they hired?
Cow?
You must have gone a different way. She is awful.
Well, I heard she was pretty good.
Baloney. Yeah, she's supposed to be tough, right? You said she's supposed to be tough. She's not tough. She's a wimp.
Oh, well, maybe it's the lines. After all, she doesn't make up her own lines.
I think she should. They couldn't be any worse.